over YouTube, all over the internet. There's advertisements for this type of service called a VPN, which claims to protect your privacy. While in recent headlines, the chief technology officer of ExpressVPN says he's a former spy and he was spying on U.S. citizens as a former NSA ploy working for a foreign government's anti-dissident spying operation. So how does a VPN work, and why would a spy want to be placed at a VPN company? What does a VPN company get access to? Well, let's look at some little diagrams here. So if you've ever been shopping online, you've seen this little lock icon on your browser, which signals that your connection to the store or website or wherever has an encryption. When you connect there through your ISP, your connection from your computer to the website, the encryption is intact. It's not perfect, but it has like no one eavesdropping unless if your ISP is intentionally engaging in bad behavior. However, if you connect through a VPN, you connect to the VPN, then there's a separate connection with different encryption that goes from the VPN to your destination. At the VPN's point, the VPN is in a position to read the traffic between you and wherever you're connected to without protection from encryption, because they're connecting to the site for you. You are not connecting to the site. You are connecting to the VPN, and the VPN connects to the site. If you have a dedicated server somewhere, you can do something like a VPN called an SSH tunnel, which is similar, except the connections and the decryption and the re-encryption, that all happens on this machine you control out there somewhere. So VPNs, horrible for privacy. You give like this one company, probably advertising on a sus site or on YouTube, telling you you can connect to Netflix in another country. But the thing is, you aren't really cheating Netflix that way. The VPN and Netflix, their connection is going to be short. They could even be in the same building. So traffic between Netflix and your VPN company costs nothing. So Netflix, happy to let you connect through a VPN. But why does a VPN so enthusiastically cover that long hop from Netflix in another country to you? Because they get to see all your shit. Like, that's so much data for the marketers if they sell it, which, how much do you really want to trust these companies? But if we look at the case of ExpressVPN and their chief technology officer, he, along with two other former spies, for criminally mishandling controlled export information, they got a slap on the wrist. They're banned from doing further classified work for the U.S. government, and they have a fine. Yet, that's it. No jail time for giving this foreign government the benefit of NSA tools and techniques. Why? Please like and subscribe for more dubiously hot takes.